The Town Musicians of Bremen is a fairy tale by the Brothers Grimm. Together, a cat, donkey, cat, dog, and rooster set out to find a new home. Their old masters had no more use for them. They end up on quite an adventure, and they aren't too old to be heroes and have fun.
You don't know where jam is? We'll come along to Brementown and you'll find out.
Going to a place where the sounds are hot. It's a way full musical melting pot.
Once upon a time, there were two brothers by the name of Grimm.
I'm Jacob, but you can call me Jake.
And I'm Wilhelm, and you can call me Wilhelm.
We're the brothers Grimm.
They're great creative storytellers.
I'm great.
I'm creative.
They told famous stories in a way that nobody else could.
Stories like Cinderella.
Rapunzel. Hansel and Gretel.
Rapunzel.
And Rumpelstiltskin.
Today they are telling us a new story.
Well, actually, a very old story.
But told in a very new way.
It's called the Brementown Musicians.
The main characters in the story are a donkey.
Hee-haw!
A hound dog.
A cat.
Meow!
A rooster. I said a rooster.
There's a fox in the hen house and he's eating all the eggs.
Well, it's about time.
Like all good old tales, the story begins like this.
Once upon a time.
It wasn't yesterday. but once upon a time.
Yee-haw! Yee-haw!
Not so long ago, or so I was told, a hound dog howled, for he was growing very old.
No longer could he hunt, so we got the old heave-ho. It was yesterday, but not so long ago.
By the road, the farmer threw her out, so she sat alone and crowed.
They want me in their soup, if you really have to know. It wasn't yesterday, but not so long ago.
Say that we're greedy. So Some people say we're the worst of all the worst. It's true that we don't care about the needy. Our concerns are concerned with you know who first.
We help ourselves, just count it when we dine.
At work or at school, if there's only one rule, whatever was yours isn't practically mine.
We take it all.
Wilhelm, we certainly wrote some nasty characters in the story, didn't we?
You mean those robbers? Don't worry, they'll get what they deserve.
The four musicians got in a huddle to come up with a plan of what to do next.
Hee-haw, those nasty robbers are very rude.
Not only that, but they have all the food.
Well, I have a plan that'll take care of that.
Of course you do, for you're a wise old cat.
Chocolate the donkey stood as strong as he could beneath the window pane.
The hound dog climbed on his back.
Then the cat got on top of the dog.
And the rooster on top of the cat.
When they were all in their places, they all began to make their own music, each by singing their favorite song.
But nothing happened. It was as if the robbers didn't even hear them.
The four stars of our story knew they were going to need some help if they were going to scare away these terrible robbers.
But who could they get help from?
Great idea!
Hee-haw, that's right. We need your help.
If we can make our song louder, maybe we can scare those greedy robbers away.
Help me with my song.
Please, come on.
And everybody in this section really howl like this. Come on.
And you folks here in my section need to help me sing my beautiful song. Please, meow. Meow, please help me. We need you. Meow, meow.
And we have the fun part. Come on, you know you want to.
all together now.
That the robbers in the cottage were scared out of their wits.
And the robbers ran.
Hi, Mommy, Mommy!
And the four musicians went inside the cottage and ate what's left of a wonderful meal.
Hee-haw, the salt is great!
This is the best food I ever ate.
Let's all sit down and get some sleep.
So the four friends lie down to rest by and by.
And the friends before us said sweet lullaby.
We can't end the story there with everyone just going to sleep.
Of course not, Jacob, because what really happened is much more exciting.
Once all the musicians were fast asleep, that same nasty bunch of robbers decided to come back to the cottage.
Actually, they sent just one back to go check if the monsters had left.
So the spy robber quietly entered the cottage where the four musicians were asleep, but he wasn't as quiet as he should have been.
The cat's eyes opened fist.
Oh my, bright claws burning like the devil.
And the cat
jumped at him and scratched him with a one good claw.
Ah!
And the hound woke just in time to bite him in the leg.
Ah! Knife in my leg!
Then the doggy gave him a good kick in the behind.
Ouch!
Then the rooster screamed as loud as he could.
Robbers, robbers, friends! There's a terrible monster in that cottage that scratched me in my face, stabbed me in the leg, and beat me in the behind with a club and screamed a terrible curse.
No!
Yes!
No!
The four musicians quickly packed up their instruments.
I've got my ukulele.
I've got my drum.
I have a cat with a cool set of sticks.
I got my egg shaker.
And together we can make music for you.
So the four musicians raced as quickly as they could to the nearby town of Bremen. And much to their delight, everyone had an instrument to play and a song to sing.
And as sure as my brother is surely a ham,
everyone joined in the Brementown Band.
Thank you all so much. Your children were such a delight to work with. They worked so, so hard. And even though I've been here this whole time putting it all together, when I see them up there, I'm like, wow, they're really doing it. And they're just amazing. So we appreciate all of your help and for being here this evening. Have a safe and wonderful trip home. Thank you. And feel free to come collect your children.